Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is part 2 in a series of repeater tutorials. Now last week, we learned that while it's not always necessary to group shapes with a repeater, there are limitations if you don't. If you haven't seen last week's episode, I highly encourage you to do that now or after you watch this episode. Today, you'll learn all about why grouping is the preferred method when using the repeater. Now, even if you know how the repeater works, please stick around because I'm going to be going over some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts, and some of these may be new to you. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at AE Juice. Check out their site by visiting the link in the description below to get amazing discounts as well as After Effects assets that are 100% free. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Trust me, you won't regret it. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know how this tutorial helped you out. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, the impressive deals and free stuff from AE Juice, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's right click in this area to the left of our timeline, choose new shape layer. We're going to open this up. We're going to add a group, and this group I'm going to call shape one. Then within this group, we want to add a rectangle, add a stroke, and now we need to add a repeater. Now, this part's really important, add the repeater outside of the shape. So see, you could add a repeater at this level, but the whole point of using a group is you want to add the repeater outside of that. Let's open up our repeater settings, and so let's make this 12 copies. Our position needs to be 0, 0. Change this rotation degree value to 360, because that's how many degrees are in a circle, and you want to divide that by the number of copies you have. So say we have 12 copies, so 360 divided by 12. So with this one shape, we have transform properties of this group, plus we have this skew and skew axis. The repeater also has its own transform properties, as we can see, and the layer has its own transform properties. It's very important to know when to affect which transform property and which transform properties affect which parts of the animation. Whenever you add a shape to a group, don't adjust the position here at the rectangle path level. You want to go to the group level. So let's just move this up. We can either adjust the scale at this level, and notice how scale is in percentages, so we have 100%. But you can also adjust the size, which is in pixels at the shape level. Now, if we make this say 50, now this is 50 pixels. It's not 50%. And a good way to illustrate this, I'm just going to take off this repeater. Then let's move this back down to 0. And actually, I'm going to add in a fill here and make sure that your fill is above your repeater. If we change our rectangle path 1, the size, let's uncheck that. And this comp is 1920 by 1080. So we have 1920 by 1080. We can see that this rectangle is being measured in pixels. So just remember that the size at the path level is in pixels. Transform property scale is always in percentages. This is important whenever you need to make certain adjustments because you may need a shape to be an exact pixel size. So we're gonna go 50 by 50, and then we're going to go back to our group transform properties and again, raise this up and then turn our repeater back on. So now we have a lot more control over this shape. Whereas before we didn't really have a rotation setting. Now we can use the groups transform and we can rotate this and each individual square will rotate. Since we have a group, we also have this skew setting. So you can increase the skew of this and come up with some really cool looking shapes. Make this like a lot smaller. You can rotate each individual one of these shapes. And then if you want to rotate this entire layer, that's when you use your layer transform properties. Use the rotation for that and see it will rotate your shape at that level. So it's really important to know what transform properties affect which part of your animation. I'm going to set this skew back to 0 and I'm going to even this size up so it's equal. So we'll say 50 by 50. If I want to add another shape in here, if I just add the shape underneath the repeater, the shape is going to affect everything above it. Go to contents, add another group, and we're going to call this animation 1. And so within this animation 1 group, we're going to bring our shape 1 and our repeater. Duplicate animation 1, drag it underneath animation 1. Now let's make some changes. So for this shape, we have a rectangle. Let's add an ellipse instead, and then we can get rid of that rectangle. Let's go ahead and change the fill color. Maybe we want to take off this stroke. If we open up our repeater, it's within our first group, the rotation is 30 degrees. And again, that's based on the number of copies you have. Well, if we want to offset this second animation, so that way it's in between the other shapes, open up your transform properties of this entire animation to transform group. Offset this rotation to half of what the value of your repeater settings on your first animation is. So we'll say 15 degrees. We can see now how it's in between those other shapes. I'm going to reduce the size of my ellipse path here a little bit. Like I said, different color, so that way it kind of stands out. What we basically have now is two primary groups, animation one, animation two. Within the animation groups, we have our shape. So it's a rectangle path with a stroke and a fill. Down here, it's an ellipse path. We're not using a stroke. Let's go ahead and take that off. And a fill. No matter what we add down here to this group, it will not affect anything inside of this group. So go into our shape one group and open up our transform properties. And again, this is the transform properties for the shape only. So this is going to affect each individual copy. And just option click on rotation and let's type time times 50. And if we watch that, we can see that it's going to rotate our rectangles individually, but it stays in place. Then go into our animation one group transform properties. And so this is going to affect the repeater and the shape. Option click on that rotation and type time times negative 25. And we can see this is going to affect the way that the entire group moves. So see, it moves around to the left because we did time times negative 25. So it is an important distinction to make. You have different transform properties and they affect things differently. We'll go into animation two. I'm going to make this a rectangle as well. That way it's just a lot easier to see it rotating. Drop that in there and maybe make this a little bit smaller. And then so if we go into the shape one group, transform properties, alt click on rotation and type time times negative 20. And if I just hide this animation one, we can see now how this second group of these green rectangles, how they're moving in place, but they're moving independently of the first animation. Okay, let's close that up. We're going to open up animation two group transform properties, add something on this rotation. We'll say time times 45. This is going to affect the way that animation two moves. Put an expression on the position of the layers transform properties, which is going to affect animation one and animation two. Wiggle 2, 50. Now the entire layer is going to move, as you can see. And then let's maybe put something on opacity, wiggle 3, 50, and we'll set the actual opacity to 50%. So that way we can see what's going on. This opacity is affecting the entire layer. By grouping your animations in separate groups, you have full control over how each animation looks and how it interacts. You're given options like skew. You can affect the rotation. You can affect the opacity of just that animation. Whatever you do to the stroke, it will only affect that group. Same thing goes for your fill. Whatever you change this fill color to affects only this group. And remember to put your repeater outside of your shape group. That way you don't run into any issues if you want to stack some animations, you want to have something else in here. So by grouping these different shapes and their animation tools, you have a lot more control how they interact with one another, and you have more control over the look of each individual shape. We have three sets of transform properties per animation in addition to our layer transform properties. The shape group transform properties affects only the shape. This is where you can rotate each copy in place, apply a skew, adjust the opacity of the shape, and so on. The repeater transform properties have a direct effect on the shape and the copies that you're animating. This is where you adjust the rotation to create the circle of shapes. Then we have the animation group transform properties, which affects the repeater and the shape group. If you affect opacity at this level, it will affect only the contents of that group. Remember, everything works from the bottom up. And finally, we have the layer transform properties, which affects everything on that layer. So if you adjust opacity at this level, it will affect both animation groups. Same goes for position, scale, rotation, and so on. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you learned from this episode. If you haven't seen part one of this series, I highly recommend you do that right now. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the impressive deals and free stuff from AE Juice, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.